A while ago, I figured out how to make this big wooden screw on the metal lathe. Now I want to make an even bigger one.
I'm starting with a chunk of birch firewood, which is just the right length. And my favorite method of center finding is just to mark the same distance from each edge and the center becomes obvious. And then tilting the saw to 30 degrees, not 45. Then positioning the fence so that my saw blade is tangential to the circle I just drew. And then cutting the corners in both directions, that way I get a cut 30 degrees from each face.
12-sided blank, only a little bit too much bark inclusion. So this is the very longest workpiece I can actually get in here.
And now cutting that into a cylinder on the lathe, but I had to reposition the tool on the tool post because I don't have enough carriage travel to do the whole length of the cylinder. And with the lathe's compound slide removed, I can now mount a router to it.
My old screw has got about a 7mm thread pitch, but I want to go for 8mm on this one. So now I'm just going to use my lathe threading table calculator program and add 8mm as one of the target pitches. And this is a program that works out all the gear combinations, and I run that. And for 8mm, I can hit that one actually at 8.0182mm. So I'll use that gear combination. Now the problem with this gear ratio is for every turn of the spindle up here, my lead screw turns 4 times, and that requires actually quite a bit of torque. And I also need to run this much slower than the motor and heel will go. But with most of the torque going on the lead screw, I can just turn the lead screw and have that turn the spindle. And a quick check to make sure I got the pitch right. Oh no, sparks! I cut into the chuck. Fortunately, very slowly, so no damage to the carbide router bit. And I have to wind that all the way back because my gear ratio from the spindle to the lead screw is about 4, but not exactly 4, so I can't just re-engage on the other end. Minor disaster. I had this part way too close to the magnets in here, and two of them got pulled out like this and then just got completely destroyed. And this is why I was winding it back and I heard some crunching noises. So here's one of the ground up magnets. And I have a few small magnets like that kicking around, but these are 5mm and in here it's 4mm. So I'm just going to expand the hole to make that fit. Gotta make sure these magnets are the right orientation by checking against the other magnets. If they attract, they're the same orientation. And these magnets are there for this hall sensor here to pick up when they're going by. And that's how the motor controller knows what speed this is running at, because that's really important, because this is a direct drive. Running steady, so I think it's okay. And a little bit of scotch tape on top of that to keep those magnets from flying out. I couldn't cut the thread all the way to the end because I was limited by carriage travel on the lathe, so on one end I narrowed it down to the minor diameter just with a table saw blade sticking out here and rubbing against her like that on the sled. And that way I can get a nut on there, and that nut I still need to make. This is the blank for my screw nut, but there's no way to fit that in the chuck. So I made this bracket here that does fit, and I can just screw my blank to that. Now if we're cutting the inside thread, ideally it'd have some kind of small long bird's mouth bit to cut in like that. But I don't have one, so instead I'm going to go in at 45 degrees and I can just barely reach in far enough before I actually hit this piece here. Now ideally I just test fit my screw into here, but that means I have to take the rotor off and I lose all the setup. So instead I'm just going to measure the minor diameter in here and check that against the screw, and I have to take off at least a couple of millimeters on each side still. I think that should fit now. Now it's hitting this plate on here. Too tight. That's a nice fit. So now I have a giant wooden nut and bolt that I don't really have a use for, but let's see how much force it can apply. So that's 100 kilograms or 220 pounds one-handed. And now it's just going all the way around, and the scale wraps at 260 pounds or 120 kilograms. I did apply a little bit of sellable finish to the threads so that they turn a little bit easier. So I guess that would probably be good enough for a tail vise or maybe for a height adjustable stool, but I don't need either of those. But I do have one use for wooden threads on the lathe. And that's making broomstick threads, because the kids like taking the handles off of the brooms as a stick and they bugger up the thread. So I want to make some more broom handles. Too tight. And that's more setup, but it cuts a lot faster than filing them out by hand.